Believing a major attack on Israel may be imminent, the U.S. has dispatched a guided missile submarine and ordered another aircraft carrier strike group to speed to the Middle East.
We have to be prepared for what could be a significant set of attacks, which is why, again, we have increased our force posture and capabilities in the region.
Israel says its military is now on peak alert. The fear is of another significant Iranian strike with drones and missiles, larger than the one that took place in April, launched from two fronts, Iran and Lebanon.
We obviously don't want to see any kind of attack or response.
Iran and its proxies have vowed retaliation for the assassinations of a senior leader of Hezbollah in Beirut and the political leader of Hamas in Tehran. All the while, ceasefire and hostage talks hang in the balance. The situation is said to have fractured Israeli leadership, with reports Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is openly feuding with his defense minister over whether to pursue a deal or fight on against Hamas.
The Secretary General reiterates his urgent appeal for an immediate ceasefire and the unconditional release of all hostages.
Inside Gaza, the situation is increasingly grim. Hamas says its own soldiers fired shots in two separate incidents, killing one Israeli hostage and seriously wounding two others. While Israeli airstrikes are relentless, killing dozens at a school turned shelter, which Israel claimed housed terrorists, and at a home in central Gaza. If Iran takes direct aim at Israel, it would all but certainly derail ceasefire talks, opening up the risk of a wider regional war. Jackson Prosco, Global News, Washington.